painful death, trapped and defenseless.
The woods have grown chilly now that the sun has set. Annie shuffles across the picnic blanket and huddles against you for warmth. You wrap one arm around her and with the other conjure a little ball of flame in your palm. Little more than a party trick, but her eyes fill with wonder nonetheless. It's so pretty, she says, resting her head against your shoulder. I don't care what they say, what you have is a gift. She inclines her face up towards yours, lips parted slightly. You lean into her, closing your eyes. You feel a tidal wave of panic drown you. You try to crawl away, but claws pin you down. You look up to see a fanged maw lunge at you. You shift uncomfortably as the wagon traverses a patch of bumpy ground. The magisters haven't removed your shackles, even though there's nowhere to run. You sigh and gaze outward. The landscape rolls past, empty and still. But then, you see something flying close to the horizon. Several things, in fact. You peer closer. What are those? Birds? Your eyes widen as they draw nearer. Those aren't birds. You turn around to shout a warning, but it's too late. The ground drifts by hundreds of feet below you. Droplets of your blood fall away from you into space. You don't feel any pain, only a numbing cold. Your senses are fading. All you can hear is the beating of the Voidwoken's wings and the beating of your own heart, only your heart is slowing. The Voidwoken seems to sense that you won't make it. It unleashes an outraged screech, then releases you from its grasp. The ground rushes up to meet you. You close your eyes.
Like this is Lohar's place, what's left of it. There's a Voidwoken on the bridge. Could Mordors have survived it?
But where's it going?
Good gods, what happened? Thank you.
sorcerer. Still wearing the collar, too.
Is this where the flying Voidwoken took those poor souls from the beach?
Dated. We won't find them by gabbing here.
I wonder where the others might be.
And tight.
I can't hear nothing. Nothing but that voice. It won't stop, it never stops.
The dwarf starts to sob quietly, with his hands pressed over his ears. The dwarf snaps around to look at you, panic filling his sapphire eyes.
It won't stop. Since we locked up Mordus, his voice, it just won't stop.
He grabs your arm, pawing at you while his mouth moves silently. His blue eyes swirl, turning an oily black as you watch.
You will die. You will all die.
Thank you.
Lucky find.